Oh.
Right.
Wow. Look good, baby. Beautiful. What a good job.
Don't talk too much about it.
Don't cry, baby. You look good. Hey, look at these hands. Yeah, well, real nice. This is nice, right? You've had that before?
Yeah.
I remember that. This is beautiful.
You look good.
Yeah. Is this your choice or my choice?
This was your choice.
Very good, ma'am. Already you're submitting to me. I love this.
Okay.
Walk this way or?
And I can't go back. And moves that.
Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Yes, I do.
Thank you. You may be seated. Stewart. Marryjane, marriage is an institution of God, ordained of God during man's innocence. The institution of marriage was given in wisdom and in kindness. Marriage is older than any human institution. Genesis 2:18 records God saying, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper fit for him." And then in Genesis 2:22 and 23, God took a rib from the body of Adam. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." In Genesis 2:24, God then proclaimed, "Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Later in the New Testament, it is written in Matthew 19:6, "So they are no longer two, but one flesh. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate." Marriage should not be entered into thoughtlessly or irreverently, but in the fear of Almighty God. The husband and the wife are charged by God to conduct themselves in a certain way in order to effect the most harmonious marriage possible. Ephesians 5:22 through 25 states, "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church, his body, and is himself its Savior. Now, as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit in everything to their husbands. Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her." God further charges husbands in Ephesians 5:28, "In the same way, husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself." God seeks to tame the more aggressive gender, as he recorded in the writing of Peter, 1 Peter 3:7. "Likewise, husbands, live with your wives in an understanding way, showing honor to the woman as the weaker vessel, since they are heirs with you of the grace of life, so that your prayers may not be hindered." It is with these profound words given to mankind by the Creator that Stewart and Marryjane enter into the holy union of marriage. "And now, as in God's sight, I here charge this assembly to declare, if there be any cause that should prevent the lawful union of this couple." And I presume by your silence, there is none. May we pray. Father in heaven, we're grateful for this occasion. We're grateful, Heavenly Father, that you, in the beginning, set in order a way for man and woman to come together in matrimony and live together in harmony before you. And Heavenly Father, we pray your blessings upon Marryjane and Stewart as they take this step. And we pray, Heavenly Father, that you will be with them as you promise in your word every step of the way, and that you will bless this union. And Father, we pray that you'll bless all of the guests that have come here today to celebrate with them. Bless each family, Heavenly Father, and may we look to you and await your soon coming. For I ask in the name of the Christ, amen.
Amen.
Stewart, you have a ring for Marryjane as a token of the vow you will make. Now face each other and join right hands. There you are. Now, Stewart, please repeat after me. I, Stewart.
I, Stewart.
Take you, Marryjane.
Take you, Marryjane.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
Till death alone shall part us.
Till death alone shall part us.
Now, Stewart, seal this vow as you put the ring on Marryjane's finger. All right. And Marryjane, you have a ring for Stewart as a token of the vow you will make. And you are joining right hands. You're ahead of me there. Now please repeat after me, Marryjane. I, Marryjane.
I, Marryjane.
Take you, Stewart.
Take you, Stewart.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death alone shall part us.
Till death alone shall part us.
Now, Marryjane, seal this vow as you put the ring on Stewart's finger. There it goes. All right. Now, in pursuance of your solemn pledges thus given, and in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I pronounce you husband and wife, and may God, before whom you have thus vowed, look upon you to make you blessed and a blessing in all your earthly ways. Stewart, you may kiss your bride. And now, face your guests. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present unto you Mr. and Mrs. Stewart Mackey.
Good.